Welcome to the training Integrate with SP API, Step 2B, Set up a Test Website Authorization Workflow. This video is designed for developers who want to integrate an application with Selling Partner API. It covers one version of the second step in the integration process, providing step-by-step instructions for a public seller or vendor application initiated from a developer's website. If you want to integrate a public seller application initiated from a Selling Partner App Store detail page, proceed to Step 2A, Set up a Test Selling Partner App Store Authorization Workflow for relevant instructions. Or if you want to integrate a private seller or vendor application, proceed to Step 2C, Set up a Self-Authorization Procedure. We also cover earlier and later steps for SP API integration in other videos. And you can find written instructions for each step by searching for the Selling Partner API documentation website. Before you begin setting up a test workflow, you'll need to construct an OAuth authorization URI to create it in and receive authorization. An OAuth authorization URI redirects a browser to a page where a seller or vendor can give your application consent to call SP API on their behalf. If the seller or vendor isn't signed in to Seller Central or Vendor Central, a sign-in page appears. The type of OAuth authorization URI you'll construct will be based on the type of public application you want to integrate with SP API for a seller or for a vendor. As a reminder, applications for sellers and vendors can be both public and private. If an application is public, it's publicly available and authorized by the seller or vendor. If an application is private, it's only available to its organization and is self-authorized by a developer who is also the seller or vendor. To construct an OAuth authorization URI for a public seller application, start by getting the Seller Central URL for the store where you want the seller to authorize your application. For example, sellercentral.amazon.com. You can see a full list of URLs on the Selling Partner API documentation website by selecting Seller Central URLs from the table of contents. Once you have the necessary URL, combine it with apps/authorize/consent, your application ID, and add the parameter version equals beta. For example, https://sellercentral-europe.amazon.com/apps/authorize/consent, your application ID, and then version equals beta. Adding version equals beta indicates that the authorization workflow is for an application in draft status. It creates an OAuth authorization URI you can use to test your authorization workflow later. To construct an OAuth authorization URI for a public vendor application, follow these same steps, but get a Vendor Central URL instead. For example, use vendorcentral.amazon.com to construct https://vendorcentral.amazon.com/apps/authorize/consent, your application ID, and then version equals beta. Make sure you construct OAuth authorization URIs for the stores in which the seller or vendor will authorize your application. Authorizations are regional. So when, for example, the authorization is complete for a Seller Central account for Mexico, your application will have access to the seller's account in any store in North America. With your OAuth authorization URI constructed, you're ready to set up a test website authorization workflow. SP API's authorization model is based on Login with Amazon, or LWA, Amazon's implementation of OAuth 2.0. In this model, the selling partner authorizes your application by interacting with pages displayed by Amazon and your website. Actions taken by the selling partner trigger responses from your website or Amazon. The selling partner's browser is the user agent that passes parameters between your website and Amazon at each selling partner action. To set up an OAuth authorization, you'll follow two basic steps. One, configure your website to accept and process the parameters that Amazon passes to it. Two, redirect the selling partner's browser and pass parameters to Amazon. Make sure you complete these steps with your application still in draft status so you can test your authorization workflow before listing your application in the selling partner app store. Testing ensures that your application can exchange parameters with Amazon and receive authorization information. As a reminder, your application will be in draft status after registration or conversion from an MWS application. This occurs in step one of the SPAPI integration process. To set up a test website authorization workflow, start by setting up an authorize button or something similar on your application website. If you have OAuth authorization URIs for more than one region, make sure to set up your authorize buttons so that selling partners are redirected to the Seller Central or Vendor Central sign-in page for their region. Once your authorize button is in place, ask your selling partner to sign into your website and click it. If they don't have an account yet, they should complete your registration process first. Your application will then load the OAuth authorization URI into the browser. Combined with the parameters redirect URI and state. Redirect URI is optional and is for redirecting the browser to your application. This must be an OAuth redirect URI that you specified when you registered or converted your application in step one. If you don't include the redirect URI parameter, the default is the first OAuth redirect URI that you specified when you registered your application. State is a state value generated by your application to maintain state between this request and the response. This helps to guard against cross-site request forgery. Note, because OAuth information is passed via URI query parameters, we highly recommend that you ensure the state token is short-lived and verifiably unique to your user. We also recommend that you set the referrer policy, no referrer HTTP header, which prevents leaking sensitive information to other websites. For this test workflow, be sure to add the version equals beta parameter at the end to authorize your application in draft status. Here are example OAuth authorization URIs for a seller and vendor application. The selling partner will then be taken to the sign-in page for Seller Central or Vendor Central. After they sign in, the consent page for your application will appear. Have the selling partner review and accept the data access requested by your application, then click the Confirm button. A page will appear indicating that Amazon is authorizing your application to access their data. While this page is displayed, Amazon will load the OAuth URI you specified during registration into the browser. Amazon will add the query parameters state, selling partner ID, MWS auth token, and SPAPI OAuth code. Selling partner ID is the identifier of the seller or vendor authorizing your application. MWS auth token is the value you use when you create a query string for a call to MWS and is only passed when the selling partner is authorizing a hybrid SPAPI application. For more information about hybrid applications, visit the SPAPI documentation website, click Authorizing Selling Partner API Applications in the table of contents, then click Hybrid Selling Partner API Applications. SPAPI OAuth code is a login with Amazon or LWA authorization code that you'll exchange for an LWA refresh token in the next and final step of the website workflow authorization process. You'll want to complete that final step within 5 minutes before the code expires. Here's an example OAuth URI. Your application will validate the state value and save the selling partner ID, MWS auth token if passed, and SPAPI OAuth code values. Your website's landing page will appear. Now let's review the last part of the test website authorization workflow, which is exchanging an LWA authorization code for a long-lived LWA refresh token. If you'd like to use LWA SDK for JavaScript to help with the token exchange process, search for Login with Amazon, then search for Add the Login with Amazon SDK for JavaScript and Authorization Code Grant for more information. To initiate the exchange of an LWA authorization code for an LWA refresh token, have your application call the LWA authorization server, https://api.amazon.com/auth/o2/token. The call must include the query parameters grant type, code, client ID, and client secret. Grant type is the type of access requested and must be authorization code. Code is the LWA authorization code you received earlier as the SPAPI OAuth code parameter. As a reminder, this code expires in 5 minutes. And client ID and client secret are part of your credentials. For instructions on getting these credentials, visit the Selling Partner API documentation website and select Viewing Your Application Information and Credentials. Here's an example call. The LWA authorization server will return the LWA refresh token. The response will be in JSON and will include the parameters access token, token type, expires in, and refresh token. An access token authorizes your application to take certain actions on behalf of the selling partner. You'll exchange the long-lived LWA refresh token for an LWA access token when you connect with SPAPI in step 3 of the integration process. Token type is the type of token returned, which should be bearer. Expires in is the number of seconds before the access token becomes invalid, which will be 3600 or 1 hour. And refresh token is the long-lived token that you'll exchange for an access token. Here's an example LWA refresh token. Your application will save the refresh token value, and the browser will display a page to the selling partner that provides next steps for using your application. At this point, your test website authorization workflow will be set up. After your test workflow is in place, you'll have completed step 2B of the SPAPI integration process and will be ready to move to step 3, connecting to SPAPI. We encourage you to watch the next video in our series to learn how to connect. Choose the relevant version of our Step 3 video based on the way you want to exchange the LWA refresh token you received at the end of Step 2B for an LWA access token. If you want to exchange a refresh token for an access token using a generated Java SDK, proceed to Step 3A, connect to SPAPI using a generated Java SDK. If you want to manually exchange a refresh token for an access token, proceed to Step 3B, connect to SPAPI manually. Thanks for watching.